now we have Dominic Phillip.
Good evening, good evening. Hi, 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 hi. Not the show you all expected to see today, no? So for those of you that don't know, my name is Dominic Killer. Not Killart. Killer, I'll come back to that. I played another character on this stage some time ago. Anyone watch the play Pussin? Not bad, no? Yeah. Next time I'm coming into power, I'm doing what my good friend Donald Trump is doing. And I'm going to build a wall. No point airports and port cities and airport and all. Wall is the way to go. So if anyone watched Pussadilla, you'll know that Pussadilla was all about four P's. Pussadilla, of course, very important. Power, politics, and product placement. From the floors we walked on, furniture we sat on, the food, the drinks we had, to chocolates, to mobile phones, we promoted it shamelessly. Loved it. Those little delicious little Ferrero Rocher chocolates that everyone loves, little golden balls of joy. We had so many of those, you're giving them for free, like going in the car, hey, matcha chocolate. I can't look at a Ferrero Rocher chocolate anymore. Someone offers me, I'm like, oh, thank you, I'm trying to lose weight. So, of course, also, y'all would have noticed the Red Bull. Yes, we had gallons of Red Bull. We used to drink it on stage, used to drink it off stage. When you're waiting to go on stage, Feroz will come up to you and offer you a sip from his can. You'd obviously take a sip. It's fun and fine because when you're on stage, it gives you shitloads of energy. But try going to sleep at 11:30 in the night after a three-hour performance with a liter of Red Bull in your system. Not happening. It's 1:30 in the morning. And then everyone is sleeping, I'll walk around the house aimlessly and go to work in the morning also. I've seen guys take off makeup with Red Bull. Hey, what's that? There's some Red Bull. I, more than anyone else, was very happy that Feroz didn't get a sponsorship from Viagra. Because you would have seen the president of Asiklan on the Lionel Wentz stage for 3 hours with a massive erection. And there's nothing that Cyril could have done about that. So coming back to my name, folks. My name is Dominic Keller. Not Kellart. At least twice a week I'm correcting someone that makes a mistake. No, it's Keller, not Kellart. No, I don't work for an auction house. No, I can't get you a good deal on old furniture. No, it's not happening. So, the elders of my community, the Dutch burger community, tell us that Kellers are from Germany. It's a fun fact. If you look up the word Keller, it means cellar in German, because we were originally wine producers. We were winemakers. That explains a lot. History of alcoholism in the family. And my mom's side, of course, is from Holland. My mom's from the Scharnheifel lineage, how it's actually pronounced. But in Sri Lanka, they pronounce it Scarnival. Small family. So us being of such pure-blooded, pure lineage, we tend to apparently look down on other burgers from like England and France and Scotland and shit like that. Like, when I bring a girlfriend home, my grandmother or my nana and my... She's probably here in the audience today somewhere. And my mom would say, darling, what's the girl's name? What? Smith. They won't say anything, but they get that look like they smelt old cheese. You know? Or sucked a lime or something. It's a nice girl, Nana. So, now that we're on the subject of names, folks, how many Gunavardhanas are in the audience tonight? Gunavardhanas, make some noise. How many Gunavardhanas? Any? No Gunavardhanas, huh? Great, that joke's not gonna work now. So if you all know any Gunavardhanas, can you please tell them to all get together and have a convention or something? and decide one spelling for their name. Originally, in Sinhala, it's spelled the same. There's no difference. So the British at some point came and said, all right, all you Gunavardhanas, write your name in English now. G-U-N-A. G-U-N-E. G-U-N-E. G-W-N-E. Pick one, make it easier for everyone else. Then of course, while we're on it, why don't everyone whose names end with Vardhana also get together and have a meeting and a convention? I'm talking about the Jayavardhanas, Vijayavardhanas, Vijayasirivardhanas, Avevardhanas, and of course the Gunavardhanas. You all have to go for both those conventions. W-A-R-D-H-N-A-D-N-A-D-H-N-E. No point, no. How many times will we cut on a form, rewrite it again? Now you would have noticed, ladies and gentlemen, that there are some of us burghers that are trying to integrate into regular society by having Sinhalese first names. Have you all met a Sandalal Vandavert? Or a Lalit Martinstein? Or a Gehan Block? No, Gehan is a lovely name. Block is also a lovely name. But not together. No? No? Like Gehan Silva. Gehan Pereira. Gehan Varasuvitana. Shah. But Block should have like a Michael or a Timothy or something in front of it. No? Even a Joel is okay. Joel Block. Nice name. Of course, then there are others who try to have Western first names to make it easier for Westerners. No, what for? Those Westerners came here for 300 years. Don't make it easy for them, stick it to them. So next time you're hassled at immigration in a white skin country, you can hassle them right back. And your weapon of choice is your name. Yeah. Now this is a Melbourne airport immigration. No? Scary place for us. Yeah. Trying to hide the Kaludodol and all that. Trying to look like nothing's wrong in the line, waiting in the line. And then you already have about 20 bottles of chutney in the bag. So this is the immigration guy, yeah, the counter, big Aussie chap. He's like, oh yeah, man. So your name is WMDJU Cody Billy. Good morning, sir. My name is Veeratna Udyansalage, Dimal Jayavansa Uduan Kanagatrage, Kodi Pili. Yeah, what was that again? Full name Veeratna Udyansalage, Dimal Jayavansa Uduan Kanagatrage, Kodi Pili. Oh, yeah, mate. Yeah, yeah. Welcome to Australia, mate. Proceed that way. Yeah. Hey, Bruce. Did you hear that fucking name, mate? Like a fucking essay, eh? Then of course there are those that are mismatched names just to mess with foreigners. I love that because the foreigners don't know what's coming next. For example, if your surname is Happu Arachi, your first name should be Manike. Not Monique. But I love when there's a Monique Hapuarachige because the Westerners know what's happening. Yeah, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We'd now like to invite our distinguished keynote speaker from Sri Lanka. Please welcome Miss Monique Hapu. Then he realizes this shit is not normal. Yeah. Now he has started. He has to finish. Yeah. Now he starts to sweat. Huh? Now his head's going in a loop. All he can see is R, C, Z, H, C, H, I, C, H, I, C, H, I, 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 I. Yeah. Now the longer he waits, the more he's going to sound like a racist. So he decides to jump and go for it, like bungee jumping without a cord. Min morning kap war shit 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 shit. Awkwardly walks away. Some of those of you, ladies and gentlemen, that sat here tonight and listened and had a good time. Some of you in the audience must be thinking, ah, come on, Dom, what's in a name, macha? No difference. Think about this. If there's someone called Chaminda Siripala, no one would care. But change Siripala to Pussadilla, and that is the different. Thank you, folks. You've been wonderful. Thank you very much. Please give a round of applause for Mr. Dino. Go ahead, oh.